With my monitor about to die, I didn't hesitate when 3 months ago a sudden deal appeared on the Alienware I'd been eyeing. Being G-Sync compatible, I immediately studied the three sources I had previously elected on how to configure it properly. Blur Busters, Battle Nonsense, and NVIDIA itself. Today's video aims to summarize everything you absolutely need to know in a simple and straightforward way. If you would like more in-depth information, I exhort you to explore the resources in description or drop me a comment below. First, the basics. Open the NVIDIA control panel and enable G-Sync along with one of two options, depending on your preference. The first for exclusive full screen and more performance. The second for a borderless full screen and easier multitasking. Just be aware that the latter may have unintended side effects in non-game apps. Then, in Program Settings, set Monitor Technology to G-Sync, Refresh Rate to Highest Available, and Low Latency Mode to Off. You'll see later that LLM is either superseded or unneeded. Finally, Vertical Sync must always be enabled in one of two locations. Here, if you want a safe implementation, or in-game, if you want one that can produce either superior or even inferior results. But why is VSync on mandatory? Because when the frame rate is within the G-Sync range, it eliminates tearing without adding its notorious latency. This would only happen if the frame rate was above that range, but such a scenario is prevented by employing an FPS limiter. Before doing so, open the in-game video options and configure the display mode and refresh rate to match your previous settings. For your convenience, here's a recap of all the changes made so far. Now you need to decide between one of three frame rate limiters, depending on what the game supports and your own preferences. While Reflex offers an automatic and dynamic cap, the in-game, NVIDIA, and Riva Tuner ones are all manual and fixed at a chosen value. Pick Reflex if you want the highest possible frame rate and lowest possible delay at all times, with no latency penalty, if when GPU bound. Its only drawback is the unstable frame time. Your second best bet is the in-game limiter, which has almost as low a latency as Reflex, but the same variable frame time. Finally, if neither of these two internal limiters were available, your only option would be an external one. Both NVIDIA's and Riva Tuner's feature a perfectly stable and thus predictable frame time, at the cost of up to one extra frame of delay. So, what value should each of these three limiters be set to? As mentioned earlier, Reflex decides on its own which one to use at any point in time, with a maximum value defined by NVIDIA, depending on the monitor hertz. In this table, I've compiled a list of them for the most common refresh rates. As far as the other limiters are concerned, I suggest you proceed as follows. If your minimum frame rate is greater than or equal to the max autocap value, set the latter as your manual cap. Conversely, if your minimum frame rate is less than the max autocap value, set the former as your manual cap. By limiting the frame rate to a level that your system can always maintain, you lower the latency variations as much as possible, which proves to be vital for training your muscle memory. And that's all for today. If you found my quick guide valuable, please like, share, and subscribe. As always, many thanks for tuning in and fare you well for now.